Hi everyone, welcome to Go Classes. Now, in the last lecture, we have seen transitive dependency, full dependency, partial dependency. In this lecture, we will see introduction to 2NF and 3NF, second normal form, third normal form. So, before that, let's see what is a prime attribute, what is a non-prime attribute. So, prime attribute is an attribute which is present in some candidate key. So, attribute is prime attribute if it is part of, if it is member of at least one candidate key. Okay. Similarly, a attribute is non-prime if it is not member of any candidate key. Okay. So this is the definition of prime attribute, non-prime attribute. A prime attribute must be member of at least one candidate key, and non-prime attribute is not a prime attribute. Means it is not a member of any candidate key. So for example, you can take a relation A, B, C. So let's assume this is a relation, and let's assume these are the functional dependencies. A determines B, B determines C. Then in this case, what are the candidate keys? So in this, from this functional dependency, we can find the candidate key. So we can notice that A is the candidate key because A can determine everything. So here A can determine everything. I can say that A is not present on the RHS of any functional dependency. So A must be present in any candidate key. Whatever candidate key you take, in every candidate key, A must be present. And we can notice that A plus, when we find the transitive closure of A, then we will get ABC. So A can determine every attribute. So this is a candidate key. So this A is a candidate key, and you can notice we don't have any other candidate key. So finally, you can notice that this is your candidate key. And so what are the prime attributes? What are the prime attributes? So prime attributes means any attribute which is part of at least, which is member of at least one candidate key. So this attribute is a member of this candidate key. So I can say that prime attribute is A, and non-prime attribute. So what are the non-prime attribute? So B, C, these are the non-prime attribute. So remember, prime attribute means attribute which is member of at least one candidate key. So this A is the member of this candidate key because only this candidate key we have. Okay, and B, C, these are non-prime attribute. Now let's see another example. So let's assume that you have A determines B, B determines C, and C determines A. Okay, now in this scenario, we can notice what are the candidate keys. So here the candidate keys are A, B, C, because we can see that A can determine everything. B can also determine, B can determine B, B can determine C, C can determine A. And similarly, C can determine A, C can determine B, C can determine C. So here what will happen, the prime attributes are A, B, C. So these are the prime attributes, and there is no non-prime attribute. So I can say in relation R, there is no non-prime attribute. There is no non-prime attribute. Okay, so this is the concept. Now we can see, so this is the concept of prime attribute, non-prime attribute. Let's take one more example, ABC. So this is a relation, and let's assume you have a functional dependency set. So the set of functional dependency is, let's assume AB determines C. So here you can notice what is a candidate key. So the only candidate key is AB. So what are the prime attributes? So the prime attributes that we have, prime attributes are A, B, and the non-prime attributes, this is C. So A, B is the prime attribute, and A is a prime attribute, B is a prime attribute, and C is a non-prime attribute. So this is another example. So the definition is clear to everyone. A prime attribute is a member of at least one candidate key. Non-prime attribute is not a member of any candidate key. So these are the examples that we have taken. Now let's see. Now we will study 2NF, 3NF, second normal form, third normal form. But before we study second normal form, third normal form, let me tell you, we will only consider the non-trivial functional dependencies. So actually these concepts, second normal form, third normal form, these concepts, they are basically, I can say, they are defined with respect to non-trivial FDs, I can say. So these concepts are defined with respect to non-trivial functional dependencies. So we will only consider non-trivial functional dependencies. What is a non-trivial functional dependency? So non-trivial. Okay, so let us see what is a non-trivial functional dependency. Non-trivial functional dependency means X determines Y. This is non-trivial functional dependency When can I say that this is non-trivial functional dependency? If x intersection y is phi. Okay, so in this situation, we will say that this is non-trivial functional dependency. For example, you can notice that AB determines C. This is a non-trivial functional dependency. I can say this is a non-trivial functional dependency. And if you have, let us assume, you consider this CD determines DE. See, notice that this is not trivial. This is not a trivial dependency, because trivial dependency means, I can say, what is a trivial functional dependency? Trivial functional dependency means alpha implies beta. This is a trivial functional dependency. When can I say that this is trivial functional dependency? So this is trivial functional dependency if alpha is a superset of beta. So if alpha is a superset of beta, then we will say that this is trivial functional dependency. And this type of functional dependency, x determines y, where they do not overlap, x intersection y is phi, this type of dependency is called non-trivial functional dependency. For example, this is non-trivial functional dependency, and you can notice this is not a non-trivial functional dependency, but you can create it. Actually, you can notice here we have, okay, so this CD determines DE, it simply means CD determines D, CD determines E, and this is trivial. This is a trivial part. We don't worry about the trivial, because remember, trivial functional dependency holds in every relation. Whatever relation you take, this trivial dependency will always be present. So this trivial dependency is not interesting. We don't care about trivial dependency. Trivial dependency will always be there, whether you consider it or not. Okay, it will always be there. Whether you write it or not, it will always be there. So this trivial dependency is present in every relation. So we don't have to consider it. We will only consider this dependency. This is non-trivial functional dependency. Okay, so the concept is very simple, that all these 2NF, 3NF concepts, they are defined with respect to non-trivial functional dependencies. Also, whenever you are checking for 2NF, 3NF, if you are checking for whether a given relation is in 2NF or 3NF, then all you have to do, remember, on RHS, just keep one attribute. Okay, so remember, this type of on RHS, we will keep only one attribute. So this type of functional dependencies, those non-trivial functional dependencies where RHS has only one attribute, this type of functional dependencies we will consider. So for 2NF, 3NF, we will consider this type of functional dependencies where you have x determines a. So this must be a single attribute. This must be a single attribute. So this type of functional dependencies we will consider. Okay, so this type of non-trivial functional dependency, this type of non-trivial functional dependencies we will consider. Okay, and actually, see, let me tell you that if you don't have this on RHS, if you don't have single attribute, then you can create it. For example, okay, if you don't have, let's assume on RHS you don't have single attribute, then what you can do, you can split the RHS. So for example, if you have, let's assume you have AB determines CDE, then you can split the RHS. Okay, so this FD, you can split the RHS. So you can write it AB determines C, AB determines D, you can write AB determines E. So like this you can write. Okay, so basically what you can do the split on right. You can do the RHS split you can do. So this functional dependencies, we can write it AB determines C, AB determines D, AB determines E. Like this we can write it. Okay, so this type of functional dependencies we are going to consider where RHS has only a single attribute. Okay, now let's see the definition of 2NF and 3NF. Okay, so the definition of 2NF and 3NF, okay, these are actually defined with respect to non-prime. So okay, let me tell you, we have already seen what is the definition of partial dependency. Also, we have seen the definition of transitive dependency. Now let us see the definition of 2NF. The 2NF definition says that a relation is in 2NF. I can say a relation R is in 2NF, is in second normal form, is in second normal form if no non-trivial attribute, remember this is very important, no non-trivial attribute is partially dependent on some candidate key, is partially dependent on some candidate key, dependent on some candidate key. This is the definition of 2NF. And another definition we will see is 3NF. What is the definition of 3NF? 3NF means A relation is in three enough if no known trivial attribute is transitively dependent on some candidate key. So this is the only point you can see. This is the only point. So you can notice the definition of partial dependency we have seen. What is partial dependency? We have already seen. What is transitive dependency? We have already seen. Now we are saying that 2NF means no known trivial, no known prime attribute. Sorry for that. So no known prime attribute. We are talking about no known prime attribute. No known prime attribute. Remember, this is very important because prime attribute can be partially dependent. No known prime attribute is partially dependent on some candidate keys, on some candidate key. Okay. Similarly, in 3NF, I can say no known prime attribute. No known prime attribute. So here this word is very important. No known prime attribute is transitively dependent on some candidate key. This is the definition of 3NF. This is the definition of 2NF. So you can notice that these concepts, 2NF, 3NF, these concepts, they are defined for transitive or partial dependency between candidate key and known prime attribute. So remember these concepts, I can say this 2NF concept and this 3NF concept, this 2NF concept and 3NF concept, actually they are defined. I can say they are defined. Okay. So in short, I can write it. This 2NF concept and this 3NF concept, I can say they use the concept of transitive dependency. They use the concept of transitive dependency with respect to candidate keys and known prime attributes. So remember I can say here that there is a candidate key here. Okay. And there is some, okay, we will see what is between, and there is a known prime attribute here. Okay. So there is a known prime attribute here, known prime attribute here. Now 2NF says that, okay, you can notice 2NF says that, 2NF says that here, okay, that here, candidate key should not partially, okay, so I can say, can this 2NF says that candidate key should not partially determine known prime attribute. So actually I can say 2NF says that this should be full. Okay, so this should be not partial. I can say candidate key is not partially, I can say. Okay, so here 2NF says that here it will be not partially, and 3NF says that here not transitively. 3NF says that here not transitively. So this is the point. Now let me tell you the confusion that many students have. Remember, the concept of partial dependency and trivial on transitive dependency, that is a general concept. Okay, remember, the concept of partial dependency and the concept of transitive dependency, those concepts do not depend on prime attribute, known prime attribute. So remember this point. This is a very important point because many students confuse these concepts, this partial dependency, transitive dependency, these concepts, they confuse with the 2NF, 3NF. So remember, the point is very simple, that partial dependency concept, this partial dependency concept and this transitive dependency concept, this transitive dependency concept, transitive dependency, in short, we will write it TD, and this we will short in write PD. So these concepts are general. These concepts are actually, they are general. Actually, these are general concepts. These are general concepts. So these concepts are general concepts. What it means? It means that these concepts do not depend on these. I can say these concepts do not depend on candidate key, comma, prime or non-prime attribute. These concepts do not depend on candidate keys, prime, comma, non-prime attributes. Prime, comma, non-prime attributes. So these concepts we have already seen in the last lectures. Okay, in the last two lectures, we have already seen the concept of partial dependency, full dependency, transitive dependency. All these concepts are general concepts. They do not depend on candidate keys, prime attribute, non-prime attribute. But remember the 2NF, 3NF concepts. The 2NF, 3NF concepts. These concepts depend on candidate key and non-prime attribute. So these concepts say that basically here you have candidate keys and here you have non-prime attribute. Here you have non-prime attribute. And now you can notice that this 2NF says that this should be not partial. ओके दिस कैंडिडेट की शुड नॉट डिटरमाइन पार्शियल एंड दिस 3 1/2 से दैट दिस कैंडिडेट की शुड नॉट डिटरमाइन ट्रांजिटिवली. सो यू कैन नोटिस दैट दिस 2 1/2 3 1/2 कॉन्सेप्ट दे आर डिफाइंड विद रेस्पेक्ट टू कैंडिडेट कीज एंड नॉन प्राइम एट्रीब्यूट्स. ओके बट रिमेंबर द जनरल कॉन्सेप्ट द पार्शियल डिपेंडेंसी एंड ट्रांजिटिव डिपेंडेंसी दीज आर जनरल कॉन्सेप्ट्स दे डू नॉट डिपेंड ऑन कैंडिडेट कीज प्राइम एट्रीब्यूट नॉन प्राइम एट्रीब्यूट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल ओके लेट्स टेक दिस एग्जाम्पल. सो कंसिडर दिस रिलेशन आर ए बी सी ओके एंड लेट्स अज्यूम दैट वी हैव सेट ऑफ फंक्शनल डिपेंडेंसीज. सो लेट्स अज्यूम दैट यू हैव ए बी सी डी लेट्स अज्यूम यू हैव ए बी सी डी एंड यू हैव फंक्शनल डिपेंडेंसीज. सो कंसिडर दैट ए बी डिटरमाइंस सी डी सी डी डिटरमाइंस ए बी और सी डिटरमाइंस डी. ओके सो ए बी डिटरमाइंस सी डी एंड लेट्स अज्यूम सी डिटरमाइंस बी. नाउ यू कैन नोटिस हियर वॉट आर द कैंडिडेट कीज. फर्स्ट यू फाइंड द कैंडिडेट कीज. सो हियर द कैंडिडेट कीज आर ए बी. ए बी इज अ कैंडिडेट की एंड ए सी इज ऑल्सो अ कैंडिडेट की. सो दीज आर द कैंडिडेट कीज ए बी कोमा ए सी. सो वॉट आर द प्राइम एट्रीब्यूट्स. सो द प्राइम एट्रीब्यूट्स आर ए कोमा बी कोमा सी. सो दीज आर द प्राइम एट्रीब्यूट्स ए कोमा बी कोमा सी. एंड वॉट आर द नॉन प्राइम एट्रीब्यूट्स. नॉन प्राइम एट्रीब्यूट इज डी. नाउ यू कैन नोटिस हियर वॉट आर द ट्रांजिटिव डिपेंडेंसी वॉट आर द पार्शियल डिपेंडेंसीज. सो लेट्स फाइंड आउट. लेट्स फाइंड आउट इज दिस पार्शियल डिपेंडेंसी. फर्स्ट यू चेक ए बी डिटरमाइन सी इज दिस पार्शियल डिपेंडेंसी और फुल डिपेंडेंसी. सो फर्स्ट यू चेक वेदर दिस इज पार्शियल डिपेंडेंसी और फुल डिपेंडेंसी. इज पार्शियल और फुल डिपेंडेंसी दिस इज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. यू चेक इट आउट. ओके आई टोल्ड यू हाउ टू चेक इट. दिस इज फुल डिपेंडेंसी. वॉट इट मीन्स इफ दिस इज फुल डिपेंडेंसी देन यू कैन नॉट रिमूव एनीथिंग. सो जस्ट चेक इट आउट वेदर यू कैन रिमूव इट और नॉट. जस्ट चेक वेदर दिस इज ट्रू और नॉट और दिस इज ट्रू और नॉट. जस्ट चेक दिस. कैन ए डिटरमाइन सी? नो. कैन बी डिटरमाइन सी? नो. दिस ऑल्सो कैन नॉट हैपन. दिस ऑल्सो कैन नॉट हैपन. सो आई कैन से दैट ए बी डिटरमाइन सी दिस इज अ फुल डिपेंडेंसी. सो आई कैन से दिस इज फुल फंक्शनल डिपेंडेंसी. लेट्स सी अनदर क्वेश्चन. ए बी डिटरमाइंस डी. ए बी डिटरमाइंस आई कैन से ए बी डिटरमाइंस बी. इज दिस फुल डिपेंडेंसी और पार्शियल डिपेंडेंसी? इज दिस फुल और पार्शियल डिपेंडेंसी? दिस इज फुल और पार्शियल? दिस इज फुल और पार्शियल फंक्शनल डिपेंडेंसी. एक्चुअली दिस इज ट्रिवियल डिपेंडेंसी. सो यू डोंट हैव टू वरी अबाउट इट. वेन एवर यू आर चेकिंग 2 1/2 3 1/2 देन यू डोंट हैव टू वरी अबाउट इट. ओके बट रिमेंबर द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ पार्शियल डिपेंडेंसी एंड फुल डिपेंडेंसी दीज आर जनरल कॉन्सेप्ट. दीज कॉन्सेप्ट डू नॉट डिपेंड ऑन 2 1/2 3 1/2. दीज आर जनरल कॉन्सेप्ट. सो हियर वी कैन नोटिस दिस इज एक्चुअली पार्शियल. दिस इज एक्चुअली पार्शियल डिपेंडेंसी. वाई दिस इज पार्शियल? दिस इज पार्शियल डिपेंडेंसी. वाई दिस इज पार्शियल? बिकॉज यू कैन नोटिस यू डोंट नीड ए. यू डोंट नीड ए. इवन इफ यू रिमूव ए देन ऑल्सो यू कैन सी. इफ यू रिमूव ए देन ऑल्सो दिस विल होल्ड. सो बिकॉज यू डोंट नीड ए. यू डोंट नीड ए. सो दैट इज द पॉइंट दैट दैट इज द रीजन दिस इज ऑल्सो पार्शियल फंक्शनल डिपेंडेंसी. नाउ लेट अस टेक अनदर एग्जाम्पल. ए बी डिटरमाइंस डी. ए बी डिटरमाइंस डी. ओके सो इज इट फुल डिपेंडेंसी और पार्शियल डिपेंडेंसी? ए बी डिटरमाइंस डी. इज इट फुल और पार्शियल? सो लेट्स चेक. ए बी डिटरमाइंस डी. इज इट फुल और पार्शियल? इज इट फुल और पार्शियल? टेल मी इज इट फुल और पार्शियल? अगेन द सेम कॉन्सेप्ट. इफ इट इज फुल देन यू कैन नॉट रिमूव एनीथिंग फ्रॉम द एलएचएस. लेट्स सी कैन ए डिटरमाइन डी और कैन बी डिटरमाइन डी? कैन ए डिटरमाइन डी और बी डिटरमाइन डी? So A cannot determine D, B cannot determine D. So finally this also cannot happen, this also cannot happen. So I can say AB determines determine D. This is full dependency. This is full functional dependency. So you can notice the point is the these concepts, partial dependency, transitive dependency, these concepts do not, they are general concepts. Okay. And still you can notice in this example. So in this example, we can what we can notice here. In this example, we can notice that we have a partial dependency. AC determining B, this is a partial dependency. AC determining B, this is actually a partial dependency. Here we have, okay. So this is actually, is this full dependency or partial? Again, this question, is it full or partial? So the answer is, this is actually partial dependency. This is not full dependency because we don't need A. So this is actually partial dependency. Why this is partial dependency? This is not full. Remember, this is not full. I can say this is not full. This is not full बिकॉज वी डोंट नीड ए. सी कैन डिटरमाइन बी, यू कैन नॉट सी कैन डिटरमाइन बी. सो फाइनली आई कैन से दैट वी डोंट नीड दिस ए. सो बिकॉज सी कैन डिटरमाइन बी, सो दैट इज द रीजन दिस इज नॉट फुल. नॉट फुल मीन्स दिस इज पार्शियल. सो आई कैन से दैट दिस डिपेंडेंसी इज पार्शियल डिपेंडेंसी. ओके, बट यू कैन नॉट हियर हियर दिस बी इज अ प्राइम एट्रीब्यूट. सो आई कैन से दिस प्राइम एट्रीब्यूट इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन दिस कैंडिडेट की पार्शियली. सो हियर यू कैन नोटिस दिस प्राइम एट्रीब्यूट. दिस बी इज अ प्राइम एट्रीब्यूट. वी नो दैट दिस बी इज अ प्राइम एट्रीब्यूट. प्राइम एट्रीब्यूट बी इज पार्शियली डिपेंडेंट ऑन, इज पार्शियली डिपेंडेंट ऑन कैंडिडेट की ए सी. ओके, सो यू कैन नोटिस. नो, ओके, सो दिस इज द पॉइंट. सो ट्रांजिटिव डिपेंडेंसी, पार्शियल डिपेंडेंसी, दीज आर जनरल कॉन्सेप्ट. दे डू नॉट डिपेंड दे दीज कॉन्सेप्ट दे डू नॉट डिपेंड ऑन एनीथिंग एल्स. दीज आर जनरल कॉन्सेप्ट. For example, let's see whether this is transitive dependency or not. Do we have transitive dependency or not? So again, the same concept. Can I say AC determining B? Can I say this is transitive dependency? Is this transitive dependency or not? Is this transitive dependency or not? So again, very simple. Yes, this is transitive dependency because AC can determine C and C can determine B. AC can determine C. Okay, AC can determine C and C can determine B. So we can see that this AC, okay, so, and you can notice C cannot determine AC. So AC determining B is a transitive dependency. Okay. And here you can notice this is a prime attribute which is transitively dependent on candidate key. So here you, what you can say that this prime attribute. So this prime attribute B. This B is a prime attribute. So this prime attribute B is a transitively dependent on. This is transitively dependent on candidate key AC. Okay. So this is the point. Okay. And now let's see whether this is in 2NF or not. Whether this relation is in 2NF or not. 3NF, 2NF or not. So let's see. Now you notice that, okay, in 2NF says that, 2NF says whether this is in 2NF or not. 2NF says that non-prime attribute must be fully dependent on every candidate key. 2NF says that every non-prime attribute, whatever non-prime attribute you take, remember, every non-prime attribute must be, first of all, every non-prime attribute, I am talking about non-prime attribute, must be fully dependent on every candidate key. So these are the keywords. Every non-prime attribute must be fully dependent on every candidate key. This is the definition of 2NF. Now let us check the same definition I can write like this, that no non-prime attribute must be partially dependent on some candidate key. So basically the same definition we can write in another way. We can say no non-prime attribute must be partially dependent on any candidate key. This should not happen. Okay. So non-prime attribute should never be partially dependent on candidate key. Okay, so let's see whether this relation is in 2NF or not. So let us check. So here the non-prime attribute is D. So we only have to check for D. So basically, let us check whether this relation that is given to us. So this relation is in 2NF or not. So this relation is given to us A, B, C, D. And the set of functional dependencies are A, B determines C, D and C determines B. So you can notice the candidate keys are AB, AC, and you can notice the non-prime attribute is D. So here the non-prime attribute is D. And you can see, now just find out, okay, is there anyone who can determine, is there any, basically this D, this non-prime attribute, is it partially dependent on some candidate key? So you have to check whether it is partially dependent on some candidate key or not. So what are the candidate keys? Candidate keys are AB, So check whether this is partial dependency or not. Just check whether this is partial dependency or not. Also check whether this is partial dependency or not. So let us check, is it partial dependency? Can you remove A? You cannot remove A. Can you remove B? You cannot remove B. So this is not, this is actually a full dependency. This is actually a full dependency. And similarly, this is also a full dependency. So what you can say, both are full dependencies. So you can notice this non-prime attribute, only one non-prime attribute we have. And this non-prime attribute is fully dependent on every candidate key. So from this, you can notice that this non-prime attribute D is fully dependent on every candidate key. So that is the reason we can say that this relation is in 2NF. So this relation is in 2NF because only one non-prime attribute we have, and this non-prime attribute is fully dependent on every candidate key. Okay, so this is the point. So this is in 2NF. Okay, so now this is the idea. Now I just want to tell you that this, many students have confusion that this partial dependency, transitive dependency, remember these are general concepts. Transitive dependency is a different concept. Partial dependency is a different concept. And 2NF is a different concept. 3NF is a different concept. So remember, in general, they can, okay, for example, in general, you can have, for let's take another example. Consider this relation A, B, C, D, A, B, C, D, E. And let's assume you have a set of functional dependencies where you have A, B determines C, D. And let us assume D determines E. Now, in this relation, we can, okay, so A, B determines C, D. Okay, and D determines E. Okay, and let us assume that B also determines C. So let's assume B also determines C. Now let's assume this is your set of functional dependencies. Now here you can notice some questions I can ask. So okay, I'm going to give you some functional dependencies and you need to tell me whether these are partial dependency, full dependency, transitive dependency, all these questions, okay? So first question. So tell me, this AB determines C. Is this full dependency or not? This is full or partial dependency? So actually this is partial dependency. You can notice this is a partial dependency. Why? Because we don't need A. This is partial dependency. Why? Because we don't need A. So this is not a full dependency. This is a partial dependency because we don't need A, because B can determine C. So that is the reason this is partial dependency. And in this relation, what are the candidate keys? The candidate keys are, in this relation, AB is a candidate key. Okay. You can notice AB, CD, E. So AB must be mandatory and AB is the only candidate key. So what are the prime attributes? What are the non-prime attributes? So the prime attributes are A, B, and the non-prime attributes. What are the non-prime attributes? So the non-prime attributes are actually, I can say C, D, E. These are the non-prime attributes. And you can notice here, this C is a non-prime attribute. You can notice this C is a non-prime attribute. And this is a candidate key. This is the candidate key. And this is a partial dependency. So you can notice this AB, this is a which is a candidate key, and this is determines C, which is a non-prime attribute. This is a non-prime attribute, and this dependency is actually partial dependency. This is actually partial dependency. So what I can say that this non-prime attribute C is partially dependent on this candidate key. This non-prime attribute C is partially dependent on candidate key AB. So this, I told you that this, if this happens, that non-prime attribute is partially dependent on candidate key. If this happens, then your relation is not in 2NF. So you can notice because of this situation, the relation is not in 2NF. So because I can say, okay. So because of this AB determines C, because of this, B determines C, because you don't need A. Okay. So remember, because of these two, I can say that relation R is not in 2NF, because the concept is very simple, that non-prime attribute is partially dependent on candidate key. So that is the reason I can say this is not in 2NF. But remember, this is a general concept. So I can ask you, okay, let me ask you, AB determines E, is this transitive dependency or not? The second question is, AB determines E, is it transitive dependency or not? So let us check it out. सो ए बी कैन यू ट्रांजिटिवली डिटरमाइन दिस ई, कैन यू ट्रांजिटिवली डिटरमाइन, सो ए बी कैन डिटरमाइन डी, वी कैन नोटिस ए बी कैन डिटरमाइन डी, सो यस ए बी कैन डिटरमाइन डी एंड डी कैन डिटरमाइन ई एंड डी कैन नॉट डिटरमाइन ए बी, सो दैट इज द रीजन आई कैन से दैट ए बी ट्रांजिटिवली डिटरमाइंस, ए बी डिटरमाइंस ई, दिस इज अ ट्रांजिटिव डिपेंडेंसी. एंड यू कैन नोटिस दिस इज अ नॉन प्राइम एट्रीब्यूट, सो दिस इज अ नॉन प्राइम एट्रीब्यूट, द पॉइंट दैट यू कैन कंसिडर हियर इज दिस ए बी डिटरमाइंस ई, वेयर दिस इज अ कैंडिडेट की एंड दिस इज अ नॉन प्राइम एट्रीब्यूट, दिस इज अ नॉन प्राइम एट्रीब्यूट, सो यू कैन नोटिस दैट दिस एंड दिस इज अ ट्रांजिटिव एंड दिस इज अ ट्रांजिटिव डिपेंडेंसी. वॉट इट मीन्स, नॉन प्राइम एट्रीब्यूट इज ट्रांजिटिवली डिपेंडेंट ऑन कैंडिडेट की, सो हियर द नॉन प्राइम एट्रीब्यूट, दिस नॉन प्राइम एट्रीब्यूट ई इज ट्रांजिटिवली डिपेंडेंट, इज ट्रांजिटिवली डिपेंडेंट ऑन कैंडिडेट की ए बी. सो एंड आई टोल्ड यू व्हेन दिस हैपन्स दैट अ नॉन प्राइम एट्रीब्यूट इज ट्रांजिटिवली डिपेंडेंट ऑन कैंडिडेट की, व्हेन दिस हैपन्स देन इट मीन्स योर रिलेशन इज नॉट इन टू एनफ. So, relation R is not in 3NF. Sorry, this relation R is not in 3NF. So, the relation R is not in 2NF. The relation R is not in 3NF. And you can notice these are the concepts. But remember, the concept of transitive dependency and partial dependency, these are general concepts. So, because you can notice in this example, you can notice that, so let's see. This CD determines E. Okay, so this is CD determines E. The next example, CD determines E. This is also partial dependency, remember. This is also partial dependency. Why this is partial dependency? Because you don't need C. So because D can determine E. D can determine E. So you can notice that D itself can determine E. So I can say that this is not a full dependency. I can say this is not a full dependency. This is not a full dependency because why? Because D itself can determine E. So that is the reason this is not a full dependency. But you can notice here, this is non-prime, but this is not a candidate key. This is also partial dependency, but this type of partial dependency is not a problem for 2NF. So remember, this type of partial dependency is not a problem for 2NF. Okay, so this is the point. So remember, not every partial dependency is a problem for 2NF. Only those partial dependency are problem where this is a candidate key and this is a non-prime attribute. This type of partial dependencies are problem for 2NF. So this type of partial dependency is not a problem for 2NF. Okay. So anyway, in the next lecture, we will see 2NF in a very detailed manner. Then we will see 3NF in a very detailed manner. But in this video, I just wanted to tell you that partial dependency concept is different. Transitive dependency concept is different. 2NF concept is different. 3NF concept is different. So these concepts have nothing to do with each other. Okay, but I can say that partial dependency and transitive dependency, these concepts are general concepts. Okay, so they have general definition. They have a definition. You just apply the definition. And 2NF has another definition. 2NF does not have a problem with every partial dependency. 2NF has problem with only specific type of partial dependencies. Similarly, 3NF has problem with a specific type of transitive dependencies. So in the next lecture, we will see what are the partial dependencies with which 2NF has the problem. And also we will see what are the transitive dependencies with which 3NF has a problem. Okay. So this is what we will do in the next lecture. Okay. Thank you, everyone.